at our chair, we started 4 years ago to form a team for autonomous driving. We started in the Robo Race, so we could gain the first experience. And when Indy Autonomous Challenge was coming up, we immediately had an initial team. We had a software structure, we had the processes already established, and we could ramp up the team within a year.
Driving a race car without a driver is a very special situation. So you drive the fastest cars at the most challenging vehicle dynamics situations. And that's something where we can learn a lot for our technology, which we want to bring to the streets.
In ideal autonomous driving means we're looking for edge cases, some scenarios that our autonomous vehicle is not ready to handle. And in autonomous driving, we have to drive like several thousands of kilometers until we have such an edge case. And autonomous racing means driving in edge case situations all the time. So we're at the limits of driving there.
The research community normally divides an autonomous driving software stack into three parts. It is divided into sense, plan, and act. And watching the vehicle your software is running on going around the racetrack with over 200 kph to pass the object evasion, to go back into the pit lane and park in front of us again, it was absolutely stunning. So I think we can be very proud of what we have achieved. We can be very proud of the team and the software we have developed.
Technical University in Munich, Germany. The new autonomous oval speed record of 135 miles per hour on average.
Motorsports is about handling limits, and our software was capable of handling these limits. That's what we all were working for the last 2 years. We were all working for that moment where we saw that we could reach the limits of handling.
I think what I really appreciated is that all of us always took those decisions together. So there wasn't a lot of debate about how much risk we want to take. We always had a very joint vision of what we want to be and that we want to like go all in on that challenge and actually try to bring that victory home to Munich.
All of TUM, the traditional kissing of the bricks here at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Everybody go ahead and kneel along this famous yard of bricks where winners have made history here at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
For the next years in our institute, we will bring the code to the street. So our next project is that we drive around the Wiesn, the Oktoberfest, where people are jaywalking, we have pedestrians, we have cyclists, and we have to cope with all those situations. The second project we have is driving in like a bit unstructured environments with cars. So the task is to make the Arc de Triomphe, where other cars are behaving not really according to the rules. So these two steps will bring us into traffic, and when we can handle those situations, I think we can drive everywhere.